So this all started back when I was, well, I mean, I could go far back, but I've always had a passion for teaching and taking things that are complicated and making them easy and understandable. And all through my college, medical school, residency, and now as a assistant professor at a couple of medical schools, that's what I do. And one day I had the honor of having a PA student, a physician assistant student, that would change my life. It's not every day that a student changes your life. It's usually a teacher that changes your life. And Kyle Allred was, he's the other half of MedCram. And he happened to be my PA student for a month. And he said, Dr. Schwell, people don't go to the library. Students don't go to the library, check out articles like, you know, I used to do. They go to YouTube, they go to Google, and they Google the question they have, and they look for the shortest video they can find. And so he saw a real need there, because as they go through the PA program, which is a two-year program, you know, sometimes they don't get all of the education that they feel that they need to get. They have to do a lot of studying on their own, and it's very time-constraining to go and check all of these things out. Long story short is we started making videos about medical topics, so COPD, congestive heart failure, pneumonia, asthma, and we started posting them on our YouTube channel. And we've gotten up to, you know, a few hundred thousand subscriptions. We were doing some videos that were very helpful. And then coronavirus hit. And one day we decided to do a coronavirus video. This was probably in late February, early March. And it just exploded, because here was this virus that was basically taking over in China. And people wanted to know about it. People were concerned about it. And people wanted to know more. And so instead of the world looking at, you know, movie stars or sports stars, they were now for the first time looking at people like you and me, Rhonda, people who had been working in medicine and nutrition and medicine and science. And really, there was a lack of communication. I mean, we have whole TV shows on sports about how to communicate what's happening in the world of sports. And we have whole infrastructure for that. We don't have that for medicine and science. And so it really put a lot of people like myself and a number of other people like myself and you on the hot seat to describe this to millions and millions of people. What is it that's really going on? And really the question was begged is, what do we do about it? And that's sort of changed our lives.